Welcome everyone to the CFO SwingerWatch Reports Technical Analysis video for the week of October 21st through 25th. Now, before I begin, make sure you guys are always reading the report first before you watch this TA video. Remember, I have way more details on what our actual swing trade ideas entail for this week. For example, I provide the exact option contracts that we need to be looking to execute on for each swing trade idea, or the exact 3-point game plan for each swing trade idea using equity. And that is just a small snippet of what the weekly report says. So make sure you guys are not only watching these TA videos. With that, let's take a look at the markets. So the S&P 500 ETF, or ticker symbol SPY, and the S&P 500 index, or ticker symbol SPX, have both been inching ever so slowly towards my respective and outrageous price targets of $600 for SPY and $6,000 for SPX. And if you guys have been wondering what has been truly supercharging this current bullish run ever since we pivoted at lows from August, make sure you guys check down below in the description box for the link to the specific video where I talk about the reasons why the current markets are supercharged. Now, if you hone into last week's price action, the price is somewhat hitting a roadblock. And if you guys can't see what that is, well, let's take a look specifically at Tuesday's candlestick and Thursday's candlestick. Let's start with Tuesday first. So obviously, Tuesday stands out. Why? Well, we've had a pretty large pullback day with a percentage of negative 0.78% to end the day, along with selling volume that was significantly larger compared to the large volume selling day that we saw on October 7th. So this came right after Monday, where we hit our new all-time high price print of $585.27. Now keep this in mind, because on Thursday, we also hit our current all-time high price print of $586.12. And immediately after that, the price went right back down, went right below the very close opening price of $585.91, and continued to drop lower and lower, and ended up closing right at the lows of the day. And mind you, the closing price and the lows of Thursday were not that far away from each other. So again, this is a very textbook, very good looking bearish candlestick. And on top of that, it was backed up by another, yet again, increase in selling volume. So there is a little bit of a pattern showing up here under the hood of this current market uptrend. Whenever we hit new all-time highs, people are starting to sell, sell, sell. And why could that be happening? Well, first of all, we are currently now in between the post-OPEC week of October, which was last week, and the presidential elections. And again, the elections will be held on November 5th. And as we inch closer and closer towards that date, we're going to start to see the growth of uncertainty. And when we see uncertainty, we also see fear rising, which will ultimately expand market vol or market volatility. So now, am I going to be expecting to see a sudden spike in market volatility this week, since it's now post-OPEC week? No. What I want to see ideally is more sideways with a lot more volatile gap ups and gap downs. And that is the reason why we hedged all of last week using those specific three tickers. And if you guys don't remember them, make sure you guys go back to the private CFO Discord. So this sideways price action, I want it to happen right over the current all-time high significant support level, which is again a previous resistance level, but now a new support level sitting at $578.50. Now, if this ideal scenario does not work out, and if we do see a breakage below this significant support level, and ultimately this rising daily 10 SMA, then at the very least, I want us to continue to follow the parameters set up by this very large macro ascending wedge or rising wedge, which happens to be a bearish chart pattern. Now, I do know that the overall markets tend to often ignore these bearish chart patterns, specifically a rising wedge during a bull market. But while we're staying within this chart pattern, we need to be focusing on the short to midterm fluctuations of the price as it continues to hit and move and oscillate between the parameters set up by these two ascending resistance trend lines and ascending support trend lines. So if you do break below 578.50 this week, I want the price to at least retest this ascending support trend line and pivot away and possibly continue to kind of move sideways in between this 578.50 level. Now, as you guys can see right here, I've given you guys and drawn a price pad structure where it seems like I want the price to move sideways in between this 578.50 level and the previous 563.50 all-time high resistance level, which is now a new support level. And why is that? Well, if we decide to continue to stay below this current significant level of 578.50, then at the very least, I want us to see some very, very wide price action in between these two levels. I have mentioned this a couple of times in the past 2 weeks, so make sure you guys go back to those videos as well. And so that's kind of the next ideal scenario that I want to see if we do, in fact, break below this level, and also we break below this ascending support trend line. I will want to see the minimum amount of damage to occur if we continue to see uncertainty and fear brewing in the markets, which ultimately leads to the expansion of market vol. All right, so that is it for the S&P 500. Let's take a quick look at IWM. So IWM, last week on the weekly time frame, it had more relative strength and more bullish momentum and price action compared to the S&P 500 and NASDAQ combined. Okay, it even felt that way just based on sentiment and literally energy wise. And as IWM continued to rally last week, we saw individual small cap names absolutely rocketing higher into the stratosphere, as we saw a lot of shorted stocks seeing some very good short squeezes and relative breakouts. And so this is a great segue into this week's CFO Swing and Watch Reports swing trade ideas, because we will be revisiting two specific tickers that we had swing trade ideas on, because they're also setting up again. And if the Russell 2000 continues its strength and momentum to the upside, these two tickers will do very, very well this week and possibly all the up into November elections. So our first swing trade idea for this week is Unity Software. So U is actually making a very, very nice weekly bull flag here. And so obviously when we first took a look at this name, we saw a nice breakout out of this inverted head and shoulders chart pattern with the neckline resistance sitting at $18.50, which is the whole number level, or specifically $18.40. And we saw a very, very good short squeeze breakout to the upside. And after that breakout, we continued to see the price holding these current highs. And in fact, for the last 4 weeks, including last week, we continued to make a very nice sideways consolidation phase, which ultimately ended up giving us this very nice bull flag on the weekly time frame. And so if you go on the daily time frame now, we see that the daily 10 and the daily 21 SMAs have fully caught up and are now coiling with each other, which means that there is a chance for the price to break out to the upside one more time for a second leg up higher to fully uncoil these two short-term momentum SMAs. Now, so far, we have been making higher lows and then lower highs, which is why we have this nice bull flag, or if you guys want to be a bit more specific, bull pennant. But yet again, those are two synonymous names. As long as you know that this is a broad general bull flag, you're good. And so with this bull flag forming, we also have a nice support level sitting at $21. And this support level has been allowing bulls to continue to add onto their positions as the price continues to stay and stick to the current highs, and it continues to literally stick to the parameters set up by these two trend lines. And so for this week, if we do see yet another revisit of this $21 support level, which I truly hope we don't see another revisit, but if we do, that revisit has to provide a very nice pivot away from this support, which is the reason why, if we do see that, we can potentially take a long entry, a bounce entry at $21.10. But if we can avoid another revisit at the support level, I would want to see personally a breakout over this flag and potentially giving us a long entry point over $23.10, because at that point we will be over both this bull pennant or bull flag, or this specifically this descending resistance trend line, and we will be officially over this descending daily 200 SMA, which has finally caught up to the price after the price broke below it back in February of this year, mid-February. All right. Now make sure you guys read the report so that you guys know the stop losses and the profit targets for Unity Software. Now for the second and last swing trade idea for this week, which is not S-O-U-N, it's W-U-L-F, Wolf. So we are also revisiting this ticker. Why? Well, first of all, let's review here. So if you guys remember back in, I believe it was mid to late May of this year, I made a specific video on Wolf and the fact that this one has been making a very macro wedge base here. And I was expecting a very large breakout to the upside because this one has been really shorted to the ground and there's a huge short float or short interest percentage. And right after that video was posted, about 2 weeks later, we saw a very nice breakout to the upside and we saw a huge short squeeze that commenced. And ultimately, we saw the price rejecting at these current highs where this yellow arrow is pointed at, and also, which is pretty close in proximity to the weekly 200 SMA. And so after this rejection came in, we saw the price coming back down pretty quickly in a span of 3 weeks. But what was interesting here is that after this pivot on this third week, after this large move down, we saw the price making higher highs and then immediately higher lows while riding on top of the weekly 21 SMA. And it continues to hold this 21 SMA. If you take a look at last week's K candlestick. And so what I want to see is a very specific play here. I want to see a breakout out of this consolidation, which has resulted in, yet again, a very nice bull flag. But in this case, to be more specific, we have a very nice wedge chart pattern. And so a wedge chart pattern is usually neutral, but in this case, I want to see another breakout to the upside. I'm a bit biased here because I want to be able to see more shorts being squeezed out because I don't, you know, no surprise here. Terra Wolf is still being shorted a lot. So the short interest percentage, which I've written in the report, is still sitting at highs, which means there's a lot more fuel left for this one to make another second leg up higher, just like you, which we just saw. All right, so I want to see a very nice entry point over $5.50, which is the whole number level, which is the reason why I gave you guys specifically $5.55 for confirmation. And so for Terra Wolf, this has been fairly recently a new trade on this very new theme of nuclear energy plus crypto mining. If you guys want to know why that is, make sure you guys read the report, because I gave you guys a full breakdown on this current new theme that is occurring with nuclear energy and crypto miners. All right, and make sure you guys read the price targets and stop losses that I have for this specific swing trade idea on Wolf for this specific trading week. All right, that is it for this video. If this technical analysis video was very insightful, make sure you leave a like down below. And if you aren't subscribed yet to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. But on top of that, make sure you guys hit that notification bell to know when I am live. Or for the people who are watching this video on Monday, make sure you guys hit that notification bell to know when this video has been uploaded, since this is a private technical analysis video on Sunday, which turns into a public technical analysis video on Monday. All right, good luck, and I'll see you all tomorrow morning.